All right, y'all, so week two has officially passed, and week two in the NFL season was pretty entertaining. I'm not going to lie, the Thursday night football game we got was very entertaining. Washington somehow pulling that out against the Giants. And then the Monday night game, it showed us one thing about Jared Goff that I will get into this video. But anyway, let's get straight into it. Let's get right into that Jared Goff thing I was talking about. Jared Goff is killing the system quarterback narrative. When he was in LA with Sean McVay and that great, all-time great offensive system, people said that he was a system quarterback and he really wasn't that good of a quarterback just because his coach was great. Well, when he came to Detroit, people thought he was going to fall off a cliff, and he's done basically the opposite. Jared Goff has been great, so he's made it all work. He has thrown for 250-plus yards in each of his first two games this season, recording 250 yards with two touchdowns last night against a really good Packers defense and a Packers team that really needed vengeance. They lost to the Saints in the first week, and they felt embarrassed. Everybody thought Aaron Rodgers was washed, but he killed that narrative and came back. But nonetheless, he threw against two good defenses, the 49ers and the Packers. And against the 49ers, he threw for 340, and against the Packers, he threw for 250. Jared Goff might be legit. Number two, was Jameis' week one performance a fluke? After passing and rushing for five touchdowns last week, he threw for only 111 yards with two interceptions against the Panthers. Maybe New Orleans doesn't really have their quarterback. Jameis Winston, after the first game, people thought that he was definitely going to be the New Orleans quarterback, but this is the inconsistency that he's shown with the Bucs. Like, he would legit have great game with the Bucs, and then the next game, he'd have one of these. 111 yards, two interceptions, embarrassing performance by Jameis Winston. Hopefully, he can pick it back up for the sanity of the Saints, but I'm not even a Saints fan, so who cares? And number three, Kyler Murray stays hot. Kyler Murray was not expected to be a superstar quarterback yet this season, but my God, has he been ever a superstar. Kyler Murray, in both of his first week one and week two starts, has been the best quarterback in his division, arguably. Yeah, better than Russell Wilson and better than Matt Stafford. That's how great he's been. I don't know who expected Kyler to be a superstar this quick, but as of right now, he definitely is. Passing for 400 yards and three touchdowns against the Vikings after he just threw for four touchdowns against the Titans. Like, the ceiling is amazing for this man. Kyler Murray, he also showed that ability to roll out the pocket and create crazy passes. Not only that, having one of the top receivers in the league with DeAndre Hopkins is a great thing to have, and he has that on the Arizona Cardinals this year. So yeah, they can definitely make a push to be one of the best teams in the league. At number four, Lamar throws for 200 yards and rushes for 100 yards again. This is his fourth time in his career doing that. That is the all-time leader in running for 100 and passing for 200. And you know, against the Chiefs, which is a great defense, which is a Super Bowl team, who will probably be a Super Bowl team every single season, unless their core breaks up or Patrick Mahomes gets washed. So the Chiefs are always one of, if not the best team in the league. And he did great things against them. In a nail-biting one-point victory against the Chiefs, Lamar Jackson showed no flaws, and people really doubting his production after having that MVP really don't know that he can do this stuff. Rush for 100 and pass for 200. That is something that any other quarterback can't do in the league right now. Teddy Bridgewater is still torching motherfuckers. I swear to God, bro. I'm a Broncos fan, so I love this a lot, but it's actually surprised me. Now, Teddy Bridgewater, we all knew in 2015, was a Pro Bowler, and he was established as a really good quarterback. He took the Vikings to 11 wins in their first playoff appearance in a while, but who expected this when coming to the Denver Broncos? Anytime when Teddy was brought up on like Twitter and shit, people would say, oh, you got Teddy ass watering on your team. Oh, he's trash. Bro, he's been one of the best quarterbacks in his division this year. Like, no cap. He has no interceptions so far. He's thrown for 250 in each game at least. He threw for 328 last game with two touchdowns. And by the way, this game that they just played against the Jaguars, maybe it's a sign of concern for the Jaguars. Trevor Lawrence, who was supposed to be this generational quarterback, threw 14 for 33. Should that be a sign of concern for the Jaguars? I mean, Trevor Lawrence is obviously a rookie, but Jesus, man. Trevor, you're getting your ass cooked, man. At number six, Tom Brady won't slow down. Now look, Tom Brady in the first week, we all knew Dak Prescott outplayed him. And Dak Prescott played a great game, and even though Ezekiel Elliott didn't have a great game, as in running the ball, you know, we all know Ezekiel Elliott is a great pass blocker, but Dak was kind of by himself in that first game, and Dak almost won that game by himself. But Tom Brady comes back this game against a division rival in the Atlanta Falcons, and he kicks ass. Tom passed for 276 yards with 5 touchdowns. And let's not forget how great the Tampa defense was this game. I feel like we all forget about how great the Tampa defense has been. Like, all the focus on the Buccaneers being great this year is Tom Brady. And yeah, Tom Brady is great. He's a Hall of Famer easily. But our defense has been amazing. Mike Edwards had 2 out of the 3 interceptions, and we forced 2 fumbles this game. Like, our defense has been just crazy. It's been attacking people, and it will not slow down. So let's make sure that even though Tom Brady is having these good games, the Tampa Bay Bucs defense is still one of the better defenses in the league. One of the best. Top 3. And for the last takeaway in this week is the 49ers will definitely finish last in their division. Now, after just eking out a win against the Jared Goff-led Detroit Lions last week, who was thought to be, you know, a quarterback who would fall off because he's a system quarterback. But Jared Goff threw for 340 yards. Okay, you eke out a win. 8-point win. 41-33. And then this week, they go and play the rebuilding Philadelphia Eagles, and they win by 6. Against the Philadelphia Eagles. This was a 49ers team that was recently in the Super Bowl, and they so-called got a steal in the draft with Trey Lance, which I don't even know if that's that good. But nonetheless, they played Jimmy Garoppolo all game this game. And yeah, you won by 6 against the Philadelphia Eagles. Your schedule so far has been weak as hell. So for you to only win by 6 is crazy. Because look at Kyler Murray. Kyler Murray played 2 straight playoff teams, and his team is 2-0, and he's playing like a superstar. Matt Stafford, obviously, is a better quarterback than Jimmy Garoppolo, and the Rams have a better defense than the 49ers right now. Easily. And then the Seattle Seahawks, I mean, they have Russell Wilson. Russell Wilson is obviously better than Jimmy Garoppolo, but even though the Seahawks defense has always had something to be desired, they're better than the 49ers. The 49ers have had a weak-ass schedule. Do not let this 2-0 record fool you for what they really are. They're worse in their division. I thank y'all for watching, though. That is my takeaways from week 2. Yes, the Bills did have a bounce back win against the Dolphins, but I mean, there's not much to take away from that. Josh Allen should be playing well, and he played all right that game. But nonetheless, that was all my takeaways, basically. The next thing that they should be concerned about, the Rams, is only beating the Colts by 3. That's kind of concerning.
Smoking on this tree, I eat with the cat, it be around me, cause I don't trust the soul.